many ways, the panorama is a work of magic. Imagine the panorama is sitting in Chicago, and 20,000 people a day are magically transported from Chicago to the prairie. They're magically transported to the foothills of the Rockies and the bighorn sheep.
It was the cutting edge. It was presenting nature in a three-dimensional form that was educational and accessible to a public audience.
This is the largest panorama I've ever seen in my life. It is so nationally significant, but it's been cared for by its community. We need to be able to keep what become our sort of heritage pieces. And certainly the panorama, there's nothing else like it.
Ron Harvey and his team from Tucker Brook & Associates will be giving us a comprehensive conservation assessment report. They're going to give us a list of options on how the different injuries that the plants and animals have suffered can be repaired.
Everything is old. Surfaces that are, you know, over 120 years old. You step on moss material, it's gone. It's powder. What we're doing in the cleaning is we're removing dust and dirt. It's very subtle. We're using dry brushes. We're not using any wet treatments in terms of cleaning. I think that this ongoing story that the panorama presented in 1893 hasn't changed. All of this material, all of these ecosystems are interwoven and fragile. Students can come here and see the panorama, which is the only one of its type and size in North America. Panoramas and dioramas become a touchstone for people. You get to go back and see usually generation after generation. Let's keep this unique preservation in place so that future generations can enjoy it.